The better developed your results are, the clearer your vital behaviors are, the easier it's going to be for you to pull together your six sources of influence and develop your entire influencer strategy. One of the most important tools that you can use to build out your influencer six sources of influence and finish off your influencer strategy is the 10X Your Influence Research Report, and in particular, the matrix on page 12, the six sources strategy matrix. Wonderful, wonderful tool that will give you a structure that you want to follow. Use this as a template. If you want, use the questions. They actually lead you to address key issues. The strategies that are identified can be applied to whatever type of an innovation plan that you are looking to implement and what type of an organizational change setting that you have. So the personal motivation is about why people want to do those things that they want to do. It's really important that you make that connection between why they're doing it and that people make that personal connection. Personal ability. This is where the PD, this is where the training, this is where you look at do people have the skills and the knowledge to be able to do those things. Very, very important. A key aspect of the six sources of influence matrix is a social and motivation and social ability. Social motivation. This is where modeling happens. This is where coaching happens. This is where positive deviance share work. This is where leadership, management, administrators provide strong modeling and encouragement. And this is really what motivates people individually when they look at these types of influencers. On the social ability side, you're still dealing with the social motivation, but you're looking at some of the tools and some of the structure that's involved. Not so much structure that you're moving into the structural ability, but things like, a Facebook page, a mailing list, or a collaborative site, a wiki, those types of things. Also setting up structures so there's a just-in-time type of an opportunity, maybe a mentoring program. These are the types of things that can play a significant role in the social ability. When we look at things like the structural motivation and structural ability, these are things like the motivators, like a gene day, a reward, being recognized, recognition, going to a conference, those types of things, being recognized by administration and by peers and colleagues a good job has been done. Be careful about extrinsic motivators and use them in a very, very controlled way, but this is the place where those extrinsic motivators can work. Structural ability, it's all about the environment, the tools, the facilities. Is the Wi-Fi working? Do they have the software? Is the hardware in place? These are those physical things that are necessary to make your innovation plan work, to make that organizational change happen. The physical thing, the hardware, the software, the physical resources. It's all about that environment. Are the environmental pieces in place? Okay. So, taking this generic example, I want to take a closer look at some very specific student examples and touch on a couple of key things. When you're looking at pulling this all together, remember this goes up on your website and you're sharing this with your audience. This is for your audience. So you want to provide a bit of a story, have a connection to your innovation plan, have a connection to what you're doing, give people a context for what's happening. And when you present the information, make sure it's easy to follow, easy to read, is very bright and brilliant. In this instance, the text is quite small, but this individual has taken, and when you click on these individual infographics, they are expanded to provide a much broader context, and is they're easier to read. Now, be really careful when you're building the infographics. Do not center text like we have here. You only want to center a heading, one or two lines at most. Don't center entire text in cells. Be careful about that. It just makes it difficult to read. This shouldn't be centered. It should be justified. This can be fine because it's two lines. That's okay. Be careful about that. This is a bigger problem here when you've got bullet points. You want things left justified. So the headings can be centered. Social motivation, harness peer pressure. Yeah, definitely can be centered, but you don't want to center the rest of the text. So just be careful about that. Another example that I want to point to, and this is a wonderful example of creating the right type of a context, a little bit less of an intro, but jumping right into the notion of the desired results, very, very clear. Connection of the vital behaviors, measurement is identified, organizational influencers, it's all right here, embedded within the web page in a very wonderful way through Scribd, works well. Bit of a connection between the vital behaviors and the results and the influencers, and then the influence strategies. Okay, wonderful example. Easy to scroll through. You don't have to click on it, but you can, and it can be expanded. But all the ideas are here. You've got headings at the bottom of each of the cells, is sort of identifying the key things. Making the undesirable desirable for the personal motivation. Addresses all the key components. Very, very good. Personal ability, dealing with, PD, training, all that good stuff. The whole idea of investing in skill building, very, very important. Easy to scroll through here. Left justified. You've got some contrasting colors that help set things off, and just again, easy to follow. And the references are always in place. So this is a wonderful example of what you might want to look at doing. A wonderful example of embedding this into your e-portfolio as well. So hopefully I provided some additional perspectives that will help you pulling these pieces together. A few more tips that will help you to be successful in pulling together and sharing your influencer strategy.